Well,
the banking circles, maybe.
Yeah, it all evolves around money. The World Bank, International Monetary Fund. I mean, they've got the whole world in debt. You know, governments are giving away their mineral rights in perpetuity. The United States government is now in a position to declare a national state of emergency, suspend the Constitution of the United States, and nationalize. And the reason they will have to nationalize is because our debt far exceeds any ability to pay it back.
So who are the collectors? What countries are the collectors?
It's not a country. It's a group of men. It's a group of human beings.
It's a group of human beings.
Right. The aliens don't need money. They don't need an American Express card.
So if the rest
it's a man-made thing.
If the rest of us simply say, we're not paying back the debt, that's it, we're starting over, you can forget your whole system, then we can erase that whole thing and start over.
That's right. If we had a real president in office, and Kennedy was probably really the last one, what he should do is just go on TV and spell it all out. Surround himself with people that maybe he can trust to protect his life. He should get on television before Congress and all the houses, the House of Representatives, in front of everybody, and spend 3 hours and give everybody a real education. Number one, the Federal Reserve is private. Number two, our debt isn't real. Number three, we've gotten ourselves into this big mess because past presidents sold us out for comfort and for money. And apologize. And then what he ought to tell, you know, and just say that I'm nationalizing all the banks under the United States Treasury. We're going back to a silver standard, just like the Constitution says, and give everybody an opportunity to get back on track here, you know, to maintain our standard of living and just start healing, you know. And then the next thing I would say is, or make sure, if there were any POWs alive, that they came back home. And I would start healing all of that crap. The fact that, you know, that our POWs were sold out because of a debt, because of $3 billion, when we've wasted $3 billion or a promise to Vietnam, when we've wasted that kind of money on such stupid things as studying the sexual habits of a tsetse fly or a frog's mating. I mean, it's unconscionable that we've allowed our government to do this.
Alex, we've got about 5 minutes left. Let's see if we can do some real brief answers to some of these last couple things, just real brief. The United States, Britain, and the Soviet Union, according to your sources, have been building secret technologies and bases on Earth, the Moon, and Mars for some time. Where are these bases to be found on the Moon?
Where are they?
Yeah.
They're on the dark side.
And do you know what the locations are, what they're called?
Yes. One is under Jules Verne. God, I wish I had those notes in front of me. Let's come back to that.
Okay. Have they told you anything about Area 51 or Dulce, New Mexico?
There were a lot of stuff there. The actual underground base is not underneath Arcoleta Mesa. It's actually 20 miles to the northwest. That's just an entrance point in and out.
This is Area 51.
This is in New Mexico, Dulce.
Dulce, okay.
It's not exactly right there. As far as Area 51, yes, there's a lot of stuff that was going on there, but a lot of that has been moved, and it's now in New Mexico, in the Sandia, underneath the Sandia Laboratory.
Diego Garcia Island.
Diego Garcia Island, there's a base there, Pine Gap. Diego Garcia Island, there's anti-gravity anomalies there, and this is how they were able to blow a lot of equipment into space without using rockets, and then they would have the UFO type craft, which we built from technology we were given. They would hook a tow chain to it, and like a tow barge, just tow it to the Moon.
Okay, and you mentioned
it runs, and the equipment that's there is run on free energy, stuff that was built in that was created in the 1920s, that we've been absolutely not privy to. We haven't had to pump 1 gallon of oil out of the ground since the late 1920s. They've had free energy, but because of money, they've allowed us to be controlled, they've allowed us to pollute the environment, to devastate the oceans because of petroleum products when we don't need it for money.
Which brings us briefly to alternative four.
When the Martian base fell, the world government, those elite, figured out, well, we don't have any place to go now. The Moon is not set up for long-term habitation, where Mars is and could be. So what happened was, when it fell and they knew we couldn't get there, they figured, well, we got to do something about here, because we have nowhere else to go. So I was told by the Andromedans that these men who think they're God had to come up with another alternative, which was they thought that they could create a controlled polar shift by detonating nuclear weapons or cobalt weapons underneath the south polar ice cap, causing it to slip, which would cause the poles to slip. And within a 24-hour period, you would completely drown 83 to 85% of the population.
But the Andromedans said that they will not allow this.
It isn't going to happen. If the Earth is going to do it, it'll be done by her will, in a natural way. And that is a possibility in our future.
What is the primary message of the Andromedans?
Grow up now. Open your eyes. Open your ears. Take responsibility for your life. Take responsibility for your planet, and realize this is your home, this is your race, and that if you are sincere in making the effort to evolve, they will meet us halfway. But they're not going to come in here and do all the work for us. Their single most important thing is, and I'll go back to that little saying, the love that you withhold is the pain that you carry. We have got to start coming together as a race. We have got to stop allowing ourselves to be manipulated.
What can an average person do? I mean, how can we reach out to the Andromedans?
Prayer, meditation. Everybody has their own way of praying or whatever. You know, and again, I want to stress this. The Andromedans can help, but they're not God. They're not our saviors. We need to be our own saviors. We can ask them for guidance and help, but they're not God. Period. You know, don't worship them. Don't worship anybody. Worship the God inside of you.
What will happen to those human beings who do not make the jump?
They'll go somewhere else.
And what will happen to those beings who do make the jump after the jump?
They'll move into fourth and fifth density. And those of us who survive this incredible ordeal that we're about to really experience will become new teachers, and we'll be able to go to different worlds and teach what we know, and be able to teach other evolving civilizations what not to do and how not to get themselves in trouble. And we have an incredible future if we can get through this. If 10% of the population of the planet can really get it together, it'll create what is called the 100th monkey syndrome, and suddenly 11, 12, 13% people will just start getting it. And it's going to take 10%. That's 500, 600 million people right now. And it starts on an individual basis. The government's not going to tell you. You know, I mean, God, we could be in, they're going to play out the second coming. They're going to try to present a savior. They're going to project holographic images in space and say, we're here to save you. They're going to do mock battle. I mean, they're going to screw with us big time. Sorry, I slipped out that word. You know, and folks, we just got to start paying attention. Don't take anything at face value. Make them prove it. And you know, whether you believe a word I'm saying, it doesn't matter. If somebody tells you that this is truth, make them prove it. If it's real, it'll stand up to scrutiny. If it isn't, it won't. Because the truth can always stand on its own. It doesn't need help, and it doesn't need lies to stand up. And let's end it there. Thank you for this time. It's been a real honor for me.